Dusty just jumped.
It's dark as heck under there.
Where are you, Dusty?
What do you say?
It's chalk and...
Okay, he went. He's under. Let's see if he makes it to the other side.
You hear dunk.
Shine the light in there, guys.
Where is he?
You can turn off the light.
Dusty? How deep is that keel?
Dusty?
He's doing this on purpose, Nick.
Dusty?
You guys go to the other side. See if he's over there.
Dusty.
This is gonna be great on YouTube.
Hey, and Dusty. Where'd he go?
We don't put it
He's
on
messing with us.
Dusty.
Oh, he's coming up quietly. He's gonna surprise us from behind.
There he is. No, it's not him. It's light.
There he is. He's behind us.
Where? It's not him. That's him.
It's
not him.
What is he doing?
I don't know.
He said he's
missing.
There he is.
I scare you guys?
Oh, we were starting to wonder, yeah.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I'm getting old.
High Adventure is just coming to an end, and Scott Sabin and Jim Scott are about ready to head back to shore.
Awesome campsite, and highly recommend hiking up to Scott Thurston Mountain.
Scott was our hero with the boat.
It was fun.
That boat bailed us out more than one time.
What about the grouper you saw?
The bass.
The bass.
They were huge.
were like this big.
They were bigger than that.
And there was three of them. They all tried to eat me at one time.
Okay, I'm talking to Zachary Evans, one of our guest scouts on our high adventure. Zach's at the helm. Tell us a little bit about your high adventure this week, Zach.
I've sailed before, but I've never been on a big boat. That was fun. And it was my first time spearfishing, and I loved that, and I think I got the biggest fish.
That's the absolute truth. Zach probably caught more fish than everybody else combined. We're talking to Kyle Bordet.
Yes.
High adventure scout. Tell us about your week.
You know, it was pretty fun to be out on the water, to sail, and to see some fish get killed. I just want to let everyone know that I almost caught a bear fish.
A bear fish? With your bare hands?
Yes, with my bare hands.
How'd you do that?
Very carefully. It got away, though.
Alright.
Now, Austin, back to you.
Austin's been interviewed by Zach. Anything else to add?
No, Austin, you have to add some more.
What kind of ice cream did you have at Goat Harbor, Austin?
Austin,
did you get any? Didn't have any ice cream. Why are you laughing, Jeremiah?
Jeremiah, what kind of ice cream did you have at Goat Harbor?
I had imaginary flavor.
Good.
Best guy.
Steve, you're up. Tell us about it.
I had chocolate ice cream.
It was heavenly hash.
Did you catch a fish, Steve?
I caught two fish.
Tell us about them.
One was really small, and one was kind of cute.
None. Talking to Alan Barrios and Nicholas Lee. They're chilling on top of the boat, heading back home from high adventure. Tell us about your trip, guys. Hey, tell us about what you guys did last night.
Oh, so Dusty thought it was funny to call me out, thinking that I wouldn't dive into the water in the middle of the night and swim under the boat, because it's dark, deep seawater, and I was kind of freaked out. But he kept insulting my courage, and the man behind the camera as well let me have it.
Who was that?
Yeah.
Who was that? Brother Thurston?
Yeah.
All right.
They were getting personal, so I decided to do it. This guy right here. Jumped in the freezing water at what, 10 p.m.?
About that, yeah.
Well, mostly this was real special for me because it was a chance for me to meet some new leaders and some new boys, and a great group of boys, real independent, very well-mannered, God-fearing, leader-fearing, really solid bunch. Good and tight, really nice to see them hang together. A lot of respect there, and that was good. This is my annual vacation, and I'm taking it with my son. I found out that he's a relentless spearfisher. The highlight for me was the snorkeling with him, you know, both doing it with him and watching him do that.
So if you had to summarize this trip in one word, what would it be?
One word. Friending.
I gotta tell you, it was pretty exciting sailing over with Scott Sabin in his little motorboat across the 26 miles of ocean. Pretty much stood up the whole way. The waves were choppy. It was white knuckled some of the ways. Scott got a little spooked when a dolphin jumped up right next to us in his wake on the boat, and it was literally, he could have reached out and touched it.
What was your favorite part of the trip?
Hanging out with the guys. Getting to know the young men a little bit better, and meeting them at Hearts.